This is what I just said, right? Probability John received treatment one is 1/2, and probability Peter received treatment one is 1/3, okay? If this is a situation, 1/2 not equal to 1/3, this is what? Experimental error, okay? In a concrete randomized design, we put everybody in a single pool, and we randomly stack 50, put them in treatment one group. They're going to receive what? New education method. And the rest 50 go into what? Treatment two group. They're going to receive what? Huh? Traditional method, old method, okay? At the end of the term, x1 bar and x2 bar, the average final score. Of what? Treatment one group. And x2 bar is average final score of treatment two group. Okay? If x1 bar is 62, okay? And x2 bar is 60. Huh? Can we say there's a significant difference? Think about it. Okay, let's think about this, okay? X1 bar, the average final exam score of treatment one group. X2 bar, the average final exam score of the treatment two group. If average final exam of the treatment one group is 62, and average what? Final exam score for the treatment two group is 60. The difference is what? Significant. How can you see this is significant? I give you an easy example so you can understand better. Imagine that there were 100 questions given in the final exam, and each one is good for what? 1 point or 1 mark, okay? So the class with 50 people, each person get on average 2 points higher than what? Still in class two, right? 1 point means 1 question. 2 points means 2 questions. So on average, each student in class one answer 2 questions more than student in what? In treatment two group. So we have 50 people. So this class altogether answer what? 100 questions right, more than this class. So this is very significant, right? Even this outcome is very significant. Can we say the new learning method better? The answer is what? No. Even if, even what? Even this outcome is what? Significant. We still cannot say the new learning method is better. Why is that? The reason is very simple. When you see the difference like this, reason number one, okay? It's because what? The learning method is better, right? Treatment one is better. That creates this difference. But there's also another possibility. Not because what? Learning method, the new learning method is better than old one. It's because even you randomization, okay? Even you perform randomization, you won't see what? 80 to what? 40. But you can still see 62 to 60. What does that mean? That means this difference can be created by what? Sampling error. Sampling error in this example means the learning method one, the new one, not necessarily better than old one. The difference is created by student who you assign in treatment one group, they turn out to be the better student right from the beginning of the experiment. Not because the learning method is better, okay? So, based on the discussion, okay, we know design three is problematic. Why is problematic? Because it is not efficient enough to tell the difference is due to what? Treatment difference. That means treatment one, the treatment one group had what? Higher class average in the final exam than class two, okay? That is because treatment difference. Treatment difference means treatment one group, the new learning method is better, okay? That creates treatment difference. Or sampling error. Sampling error means what? The new method is no better than old method. The difference is created by what? You put better student into what? Treatment one group right from the beginning. And it has nothing to do with what? The treatment one is better treatment or not. Okay? It's because sampling error. So design three is problematic. It is not efficient enough to tell the difference is created by treatment difference or sampling error. Okay? Look at design four. Design four is new design. Fix the problem you see in design three. Randomly select 100 pair of twins. What do you know about twins? Twins come from the same family. They have the same parents. So genetically, they are almost identical. That means their IQ level are the same. And not just the IQ level are the same, right? Since they come from the family, their economic social status are also the same. Okay, that means, think about this. You don't want to compare the children from rich family to children come from the poor family, because the learning resource available, they are definitely what? Different. Okay, so if you randomly select what? 100 pair of twins, and the comparison is among what? Within the pairs of twins. That makes the comparison become very efficient, okay? And which one use the first treatment is decided at random, okay? Look at here. Say I have 100 pair of twins. John, Tom. Mary, Minnie. Todd, Ted. To what? Fred, Peter, okay? Now in this two tuple notation, the first person in the two tuple, this is called two tuple notation. The first two person in the two tuple is the elder one of the twin. And the second person, Tom, is what? The younger of the twin, okay? So John is an elder twin, and his younger twin brother is Tom. Same thing. Mary is elder, May is junior, okay? Todd is elder, Ted is what? Junior, okay? Among the twin. So the comparison is what? Among the twin. But randomization is still important, okay? The which treatment, which one of the twin going to receive the first treatment is decided at random. What does that mean? Let me explain, okay? Okay, let's look at this example. Suppose we flip a fail coin 100 times. A fail coin means what? Pi is a chance of getting heads. Chance of getting heads is 50%. If you have 50% chance of getting heads, you have 50% chance of getting tail. 50-50, that's why I call this is fail coin. Say we flip a fail coin 100 times. On each flip, we observe we get a head or we get a tail. If we see a head, then the elder one use what? Treatment one. That means elder one going to receive the new learning method. And the younger one going to use what? The old learning method. Okay? Now, if on the case flip we see a tail, then elder one during treatment two going to learn what? Old method. Okay? And the younger of the twin during treatment one, the younger of the twin going to receive the new learning method. Okay? Say the below is a realization of this 100 flip. First one, we see a head. Second one, we see a tail. The next one, we see a head again. And to the very last flip, 100 flip, we see what? We see a tail. So what does that mean? Okay, look at here. When we see a head, the elder one join what? The new learning method group, treatment one group, and the younger one join what? Treatment two, the old method, okay? So look at, if the first one is head, John is the elder one join John joined what? The new learning method group. And Tong joined what? The traditional. Okay? So this is treatment one group, treatment two group. Treatment one group use new learning method. And treatment two group, they use traditional one. Okay? Now, since the first sweep is ahead, okay? First sweep is ahead. And when we see ahead, either one of the twin join treatment one group, that means he or she going to receive what? Huh? New learning method. John going to receive what? The new learning method. And his younger twin brother Tom going to receive the old traditional learning method. Okay? So John is in what? Treatment one group. And his younger twin brother Tom join what? The treatment two group. Okay? Treatment two group. And next one is Tail. Tail is what? Tail is a younger one join treatment one group, use new learning method. And the older one, the elder one, use what? The new one. Okay? So in this case, May going to receive the new learning method. And her elder what? Twin sister, Mary, going to use what? The old learning method. And next one, head again. So Todd going to what? Todd is what? Todd is the elder one. Okay? Todd is going to use what? The new learning method. And the younger of the twins, Ted, join what? Treatment two group. And so on and so forth. Up to the last one, Fred and Peter, okay? It's what? It's Tail. So younger one, Peter, join what? Treatment one group, receive the new learning method, okay? And his elder twin brother, Fred, join what? Treatment two group, use what? Old learning method, okay? And then, at the end of the semester, X1, say X1 bar, the first treatment group is 62. And average final exam of the treatment group, which uses the traditional old learning method, gets 60. Now, when we know this is significantly what? Higher than this group, right? 62 is significantly higher than 60, okay? So, since the comparison is made among what? Twins. Other than learning method, all other factors you can think of, they are almost what? Exactly the same. So, make the comparison become very efficient. So, when you see X1 bar is 62, okay? And X2 bar is 60. Since this is a match pair design, we feel comfortable, okay, to conclude. Treatment one, use what? New method is better than treatment two. Why we are so comfortable? Because we use match pair design, okay? The individual put in what? The same pair. They are very similar. In our case, we put twins, okay? Twins come from the same family. They have the same IQ level. They have the same what? Learning resource available. All the factors you can think of, they are almost identical. Except what? Except the learning method, okay? Now, there's another question. Why you make the comparison? You need to randomize. Sometimes it's the elder one put in treatment one. Sometimes it's what? Younger one put in the treatment one. If you don't do that, then the birth order can be another lurking variable affect the outcome. That is to say, if you don't perform randomization to determine the elder one joining the treatment one group or the younger one joining the treatment one group, if you don't do randomization, then that difference may be due to what? Huh? Birth order again, okay? So that's why you want to use what? Randomization, okay?